In this video, we're going to finish the Systems of Equations worksheet, solving by using elimination, on the KutaSoftware website under the Infinite Algebra 1 section. Picking up with number 17, in the first video where we were able to either add or subtract right off the bat, in the second video, we had to multiply one of the equations, but now, in this third video, we're going to be multiplying both equations in order to find a common multiple or a common number for the variables. So let's look at the x values. We have negative 7x and negative 4x. 7 and 4 go into 28 evenly. So that would be multiplying the first equation by 4 and the second equation by 7. 4 times negative 7 is negative 28x minus 4 times 8, which is 32, and that's multiplied by y, and then 9 times 4 is 36. That's going to be equal to 7 times negative 4x, negative 28x, plus 7 times 9y, 63y, and that's equal to 7 times negative 22, which is negative 154. In order to cancel out the negative 28x, I'm going to subtract negative 28x minus a negative 28x is 0x, negative 32 minus a positive 63 is negative 95y, and that's equal to 36 minus a negative 154, which is 36 plus 154, which is equal to 190. When I divide both sides by negative 95, I'll be able to isolate my y, since 0 times x is 0. Negative 95y divided by negative 95 is y, and 190 divided by negative 95 is the negative 2. So now that I know that y is negative 2, I'll plug y in and then solve for x. So using this second equation, I'll have negative 4x plus 9 times negative 2 equal to negative 22. So negative 4x plus 9 times negative 2 is negative 18, and that's equal to negative 22. So if I add 18 to both sides, I'll get that negative 4x is equal to a negative 4. And dividing by negative 4, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 1. So my solution in number 17 is 1 for x and negative 2 for y. In number 18, looking at x again, I'll just have to multiply my first equation by 3 and my second equation by 5. Multiplying my first equation by 3, I'll get 15x, and when I multiply my second equation by 5, I will also have 15x. So finishing out the math in my first equation, 3 times 4y is 12y, and 3 times negative 30 is negative 90. 5 times 9y, I'll be subtracting a 45y, and that's going to be equal to 5 times negative 18, which is also negative 90. Now in order to cancel out my 15x, I'll subtract the equations. So 15x minus 15x is 0x, and 0x is simply 0. 12y minus a negative 45y is the same as 12y plus 45y, which is 57y, and that's equal to negative 90 minus a negative 90, which is negative 90 plus 90, which is 0. So dividing by 57, I'll get that y is equal to 0. So knowing that y is 0, I'll plug 0 in for y and solve for x. I'll go ahead and just use my first equation. So 5x plus 4 times 0 equals negative 30. 4 times 0 is 0, so 5x equals negative 30, and dividing by 5, I'll get that x is equal to negative 30 divided by 5, which is negative 6. So for number 18, negative 6, 0 is my solution. Moving on to number 19, for x, I could multiply the top equation by 10 and the bottom equation by 4, but if I'm looking at y, I can simply multiply the top by 7 and the bottom by 2. So I'll go ahead and do that. Multiplying the top equation by 7, I'll have 14y, and multiplying the bottom equation by 2, I'll also have a 14y. So 7 times negative 4x is negative 28x, minus 7 times 2y, 14y, and that's equal to 7 times 14, which is 98. 2 times negative 10x is negative 20x. 2 times 7y is 14y. And 2 times negative 25 is negative 50. Now, in order to cancel out this negative 14y, I will need to add my second equation. So negative 28x plus a negative 20x is a negative 48x. Negative 14y plus a positive 14y is 0y. And 98 plus a negative 50 is 48. So negative 48x equals 48. And when I divide by negative 48, I'll get that x is equal to negative 1. So if x is negative 1, when I plug negative 1 in for x, I'll use this first equation. Negative 4 times negative 1 minus 2 times y equals a positive 14. Negative 4 times negative 1 is a positive 4. Subtracting 2y will equal 14. Now I'll subtract 4 from both sides to get that negative 2y equals a positive 10. And when I divide by negative 2, I'll get that y is equal to 10 divided by negative 2, which is a negative 5. So for 19, negative 1 is x, and negative 5 is y. That is solving by elimination. I eliminated my y variable, solved for x, and then used x to solve for y. And number 20, I'll go ahead and cancel out my y's. So I'm going to be eliminating my y's, and in order to do that, I need to make a common y term. So 2y and 5y, I can make each of those 10y. So if I multiply the first equation by 5 and the second equation by 2, 3x times 5 is 15x minus 2y times 5, which is 10y, and that's equal to 2 times 5, which is 10. 5x times 2 is 10x minus 5y times 2, which is 10y, and that's equal to 10 times 2, which is 20. Now I'm going to need to subtract that bottom equation. 15x minus 10x is a positive 5x. Negative 10y minus a negative 10y is negative 10y plus 10y, which is 0y, and that's equal to 10 minus 20, which is negative 10. Dividing both sides by 5, I'll isolate my x to get that x is equal to negative 2. Negative 10 divided by 5 is negative 2. Now that I know that x is negative 2, I'll plug that in. Let's use that first original equation. So 3 times negative 2 minus 2y equals a positive 2. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6, and I'm subtracting 2y, and that will give me a positive 2. Now if I add 6 to both sides, my negative 6 will cancel out, and I'll have that negative 2y is equal to 2 plus 6, which is 8. And finally, I'll divide by negative 2 to solve for my last variable, y, which is equal to negative 4, since 8 divided by negative 2 is negative 4. So negative 2, negative 4 is my solution in number 20. Now, just to give you an example, I'm going to be using division this time as opposed to multiplying my equations. So I'm going to divide and find a common term for my y values. Or instead of thinking of it as dividing, I'll multiply by a fraction. So if I multiply this top by 1/2, I'll get 2y. And if I multiply the bottom by 1/3, I'll get 3y. So essentially, I can think of that as dividing the first equation by 2 and dividing the second equation by 3. So I'll have 5/2 x plus 4y times 1/2, or 4y divided by 2. Is a positive 2y, that's equal to negative 14 divided by 2, which is negative 7. 3x divided by 3, or times 1/3, is 1x. And then 6y divided by 3 is 2y, and that's equal to 6 times 1/3, or 6 divided by 3, is 2. Now, in order to cancel out or eliminate my 2y, or my variable y, I'm going to need to subtract this second equation. So 5/2 x minus 1x, you can think of 5/2 x minus 2/2 x, which is 3/2 x. And then 2y minus 2y is 0y, and that's equal to negative 7 minus 2, which is negative 9. Now 0 times y is 0y. In order to cancel out this 3/2, I'm just going to multiply by that reciprocal of 2/3. And I have to do that to both sides. So my 2 and my denominator will cancel out, and my 3 from my numerator will cancel out. So you can think of this as multiplying by 2 and then dividing by 3. So I'll get that x is equal to negative 9 times 2, which is negative 18, and then dividing that by 3, we will get negative 6. So now that we know that x is negative 6, I'll plug x in to either of my equations and solve. So let's plug x in for the second equation that we modified. 1 times x, if x is negative 6, we'll have negative 6, plus 2y equals a positive 2. So adding 6 to both sides, I'll get that 2y equals 2 plus 6, which is 8. And then when I divide by 2, I'll get that y is equal to a positive 4. So for number 21, negative 6 is x, and positive 4 is y. In number 22, I'll work to eliminate my x variable. So I'll multiply the top equation by 5 and the bottom equation by 2. So 10x plus 40y equals 30. And that's distributing my 5 to each of the terms. Then I'll have negative 10x minus 40y equals negative 30. And that was distributing the 2 to each of my terms. Now, in order to cancel out or eliminate that x, I'll simply add that second equation. So 10x plus a negative 10x is 0x. 40y plus negative 40y is 0y. And 30 plus negative 30 is 0. So I have 0x plus 0y equals 0. So essentially, 0 equals 0. That means that there's multiple numbers that I can plug in. There is not one solution. There is an infinite number of solutions. And there's an infinite number of solutions. Well, we got that 0 was equal to 0 when we solved by elimination. But these are essentially the same exact line. 10x plus 40y equals 30. And then we have negative 10x minus 40y equals negative 30. Well, if we were to multiply this bottom equation by negative 1, we would get 10x plus 40y equals 30. So these equations are equivalent. Therefore, if we were to graph them, we would graph the same exact line. So there is an infinite number of solutions because they are the same. In number 23, we mix things up a bit because now we don't have our variables just on one side of the equation. They're on two separate sides. Now I want to rearrange this bottom equation so that my variables are on the same side, or rearrange the top equation to where my y variable and my constant's on the same side so that they look the same. So let's just rearrange this bottom equation. All I need to do is subtract 10y from both sides. In doing that, I'll have that 4 is equal to negative 10y plus 2x. So now my y and x are both on the right-hand side of that equation. Now, my next step, I'm going to be eliminating this negative 20y. In order to do that, I need to multiply this bottom equation by 2. So rewriting my top equation, I'll have negative 14 equals negative 20y minus 7x. Manipulating my bottom equation by multiplying it by 2, 2 times 4 is 8, and that's equal to 2 times negative 10y, which is negative 20y, plus 2x times 2, which is plus 4x. Now, in order to cancel out that 20y, or the negative 20y, in the bottom and the top, I will be subtracting these equations. So negative 14 minus 8 equals negative 22. Negative 20y minus negative 20y is 0. And negative 7x minus 4x is negative 11x. Since that 7x is subtracted, when I subtract 4x from it, I'll be taking away 11x, essentially negative 11x. So now when I divide both sides by negative 11, I'll get that positive 2 is equal to x, since negative 22 divided by negative 11 is positive 2. Now I'll take this value of 2 and plug it in to any of my equations. Let's plug it into this bottom equation. So 10y plus 4 equals 2 times 2. So 10y plus 4 equals 4. Subtracting 4 from both sides, I'll get that 10y is equal to 0, since 4 minus 4 is 0. And dividing by 10, 0 divided by any number is 0, so y is equal to 0. So number 23, my x value is 2, and my y value is 0. And lastly in this video, number 24. Now, before I go over number 24, don't forget to click that like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Now for number 24, I'm going to start by rearranging this top equation. And I'll do so by subtracting 2x from both sides. So I'll have 3 minus y equals negative 2x. And you can see that that's in the same format as my second equation, where my constant and y are on the same side and x is on one side of the equation. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to cancel out my x. So if I'm going to be canceling out my x, in the top equation I have negative 2x, in the bottom equation I have 10x. So I'm going to need to multiply this top equation by 5 in order to get either a negative 10x or a positive 10x. So 5 times 3 is 15 minus y times 5, which is minus 5y, and that's equal to negative 2x times 5, which is negative 10x. Now rewriting my bottom equation, I'll have negative 3 minus 7y equal to 10x. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to be adding this bottom equation. 15 plus negative 3 is a positive 12, negative 5y plus negative 7y is a negative 12y, and negative 10x plus 10x is 0x, which is simply 0. So now I'll add 12y to both sides in order to get my term with y on one side of my equation and my constant on the other. So I'll have 12 equal to 12y, and when I divide by 12, I'll get that 1 is equal to y. So if y is 1, I'll take that value of 1 and plug it into any of my equations. Let's plug it into this bottom equation. So I'll have negative 3 minus 7 times 1 equal to 10x. So that's negative 3 minus 7 equals 10x. Negative 3 minus 7 is negative 10. And if that's equal to 10x, when I divide by a positive 10, I'll get that negative 1 is equal to x. So for number 24, negative 1 is x and 1 is y. Negative 1, 1 is my final solution on this worksheet. If you didn't do so before number 24, remember to like, subscribe, and share. And if you have any questions or just want to leave me a note, put it in the comments below.